Now, we'll take up one more problem on projections of points where we are going to have the combination of quadrants. A point 30 mm above xy line is the front view of three points now, P, Q, and R. The top view of R is 40 mm behind VP. The top view of Q is on xy line, and the top view of capital P is 45 mm in front of VP. Draw the projections of the points and state the quadrant in which the points are situated. So a point 30 mm above xy line, you have an xy line. Above xy line is the front view of three points. So from here you measure 30 mm and you mark this as front view of three points, capital P, capital Q, and capital R. Therefore, you are going to get it as P dash, Q dash, and R dash. The top view of R is 40 mm behind VP. Where you are going to get the behind VP? The behind VP will going to come in the second quadrant. So 40 mm behind VP. So when you look from the top view, we can see the distance behind VP, which will be on HP. The top view of Q is on XY line. So the top view of Q is on XY line here. When you look from the top view, it will going to be on this XY line. The top view of P is 45 mm in front of VP. Where you're going to get 45 mm in front of VP? The in front of VP, when you look from the top view, it will going to be on HP. So it will be on HP now. So this is how. So it is in the first quadrant. Draw the projections of the points and state the quadrants in which the points are situated. So when you are rotating this first quadrant down, what happens to the top view of P? The top view of P will come below XY line of 45 mm. The top view of Q is on XY line, so the top view of Q is on XY line. So when the front view is, when the top view is rotated down in the first quadrant, what happens to the top view of the point? Top view of the point in the second quadrant, it will go above XY line. Therefore, from here, the top view of R is taken 40 mm behind VP. So you will going to get this. Once you get this, so we have drawn this. State the quadrants in which the points are situated. So first is P dash is above XY line and P is below XY line. So obviously it is in first quadrant. So capital P is in first quadrant. Since Q is on XY line, if Q is go to the above XY line, then it becomes for the second quadrant. If Q comes below XY line, then it becomes the first quadrant. But it is on XY line. Therefore, Q dash will go, the capital Q lies first as well as second quadrant. And capital R is in, and capital R, if you see here, R, both R front view and the top view is above XY line. Therefore, capital R is in second quadrant. So this is how we can analyze this problem of the combination of quadrants. Now we will try to solve this problem by using AutoCAD software. So here, first we'll go to the AutoCAD screen, switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode. Now we will go to start with the limits command. So type limits. Specify lower left corner 0, 0, upper right corner is 297, 210, then zoom all, then go to line command, take some arbitrary point and click on first button of the mouse and drag the mouse towards the right side, take some distance, and again you click on the first button of the mouse, and again you drag the cursor to the top side, take some distance and click on the first button of the mouse, and then enter key, then go to offset, take the distance as 297. You select this vertical line and offset to the left side of the entity, and then go to offset, take the distance as 210. So because we are trying to draw the A4 size, then go to offset, select this offset or select the horizontal line and offset to the top side. Then go to zoom extents and then zoom 0.6x. Then go to fillet, select between these two, and you select between this line and also this vertical line, and you select between this vertical line and this horizontal line, then take zoom window. And now we need to type the problem. Now to type the problem, take point capital, a point 30 mm above xy line is the front view of three points, capital P, capital Q, and R. So here we'll go for dtext, put up the caps lock, specify start point, you select some point and take the height as 4 and rotation angle as 0, and take 26th problem, a point 30 mm above xy line, a point 30 mm above xy line, above xy line is the front views of three points, capital P, comma capital Q and R. The top view of capital R is 40 mm behind VP. The top view of capital R is 40 mm behind VP. Behind VP, comma. Then top view of Q is on XY line. The top view of Q, capital Q, is on XY line. And top view of P is 45 mm in front of VP. And top view of capital P is 45 mm in front of VP. Draw the projections of the points. Projections of the point. And state the quadrants in which the points are situated. So this is the problem which is given to you. So first we'll go for, so what I'm trying to concentrate now, I want to concentrate on how to solve this problem by using this AutoCAD software. So to do that, so first we'll go for layer command. Click on new, type the layer by name XY, then click on new, type the layer by name front view, and click on new, type the layer by name top view. So then go to layer 0, line weight as 0.05, okay, and layer XY you take it as 0.13, then you take the front view color as magenta color, then you take the top view color as red. Okay, and then close it. Now we'll go for the line command. So first we'll going to draw a line and then draw a vertical line, and then we're going to give the dimensions like this. So to do that, so I'll go for a line command, draw first one horizontal line of some distance, and similarly draw a vertical line of some distance. Then go to 30 mm above XY line. So go to offset, take the distance as 30, you select this and offset to the top side. And the top view of R is 40 mm behind VP. So then go to offset, take the distance as 40, and you select this here. Then go to the top view of P is 45 mm. So you take offset, take the distance as 45. You select this line and bring it here. Then go to zoom previous. Then go to zoom window. Then go to trim. Select this at the cutting edge and this at the object to trim. So select this at the cutting edge and object to trim at this. Then go to erase, erase this line and also erase this line. Then go to donut, so take 0 and take 3 and take int of this and take endpoint of this and endpoint of this. So once you do that, then go to erase, erase this, then go to break, break this line till here and break this line till here. Then go to t-text. So here what we need is P dash, Q dash, R dash. So here you take this text type. So here you take d text, select this text here and type text height as 3 and go to X, capital X, and you take capital Y, and here you take small letters P dash, then Q dash, then R dash, then here R, here P, and here you mark this as Q. Then go to break, break this line till here, then go to donut, take intersection part of this now. Then go to move, switch off the ortho mode, you select X and bring it nearer like this. Similarly, you bring this here. So then go to zoom previous, then go to zoom entire thing you take here, then go to move. So take P here, then you take Q here, and then you take P dash, and all should be on the same point because that is the front view of the 3 points will be above XY line. So you take top view. So now you keep it here. So now we go for the front view. You select this, go to CH, go to layer, make this as front view now. And similarly, you select this, go to CH, go to layer, you make this layer as XY. Then you just go to R and you just go to Q and then P. All are related to top view. So go to layer, you make this as top view layer. Now once you get this, now we will go for DDIM, that is the dimensioning. Do again, go to modify, then take the offset from the origin as 2. Then lines and symbols and arrows, take the arrow size as 3. Go to text, take the text height as 3. Then align with the dimension line, center becomes above, and take this dimension as 2. Then go to primary units, make this linear dimension as 0, and say OK, and say close. Now we will go for dim. Now we will go for dim. Go to center of this. Center of this and take center of this now, because both are having the donut there. So again go to dim, center of this, go to dim, take center of this and take center of this and take this height as 30. Again center of this, and again you take center of this and you take the dimension as 40. Then go to zoom previous. Now we're going to write the answer here. So to write the answer, so point capital P is in first quadrant, Q is the first as well as second, and capital R is in second quadrant. So here I will just go to the text height and type it as answers. So here bring it. So go to the text. So point capital P is in first quadrant. Then capital Q is in first as well as second quadrant. Second quadrant. And capital R is in second quadrant. So this is how you will be able to write the answer. Then go to line and switch off the ortho mode and write it in a box. So it will be in a box. Go to erase, then go to move, switch off the ortho mode, so you keep it the answer here. So this is how you will be able to get the final answer for this particular problem number 26. So this is about the combination of quadrants. So this is how we can solve this problem by using AutoCAD software. Thank you.